DDL is Executive Director of Kids Hub Child Advocacy Center for joining me. Their Black Tie Bingo at the Barn happening August 17th. If you want to know more, go to kidshubms.com. You can also call them 601-909-6294. And we look forward to creating a partnership with them and getting the word out and helping to educate people when it comes to child abuse, because it's just shocking, the numbers, considering the area. And again, it's not a topic you really want to hit on a whole lot. Like to put the blinders on and pretend it's not happening, but it is, and it takes the community to get involved. So we really appreciate her coming in. Coming up, we're going to do William Carey Wednesday at 9:36. Also take a look at area events. But first, let's talk about Anatomies. Join me in studio, Patrick Ruby.
Good to see you. Hey, good morning, Michael. How are you?
I am good, busy, nonstop. I'm sure you hear that a lot, so I'll just stop there.
But Michael, we live it.
Yeah, you can't get away from it. It's just how you deal with it.
Right.
That's the reality.
Right.
You have a very special guest in studio, and let's just say right at the top, legal disclaimer, results not typical. But possible.
They are. And if anyone can tell you about it, it's Billy. And our guest today is Billy Carter. And he's been connected to the facility for, over a year, 2 years?
Yeah, a couple of years.
And so, you know, we've been watching. And he's one of these guys, he just kind of like speaks and he goes and does his thing. But you just watch him like, man, something's going on with him. And I'll tell you what's been going on with him. Since January, he's dropped over 70 pounds.
79 pounds.
That's almost 80 pounds since January. Now, that's a very aggressive pursuit in weight loss. But he has an athletic background. He's dedicated so much of his effort and energy. And it just goes to show that when you connect with something and you set up the parameters around, you can get success, you know. And so he's just a living example of this. And I thought we'd talk to him about, you know, his journey and about how much freedom it's given his life to get that weight off of him.
And that's one of the big things we try to really push on this program whenever we have Patrick on, is to instill that to people. But a lot of times just telling them doesn't work. So to have an example like you, Billy, how did you get to this point? How did you get here?
Well, you know, it's like anything. You go through life, a lot of times you're looking for a fastball, and life will throw you a curveball. Mm-hmm. About 2 or 3 years ago, my mom had a very tragic accident drowned in a swimming pool. Really threw me for a loop. I was just getting over my brother dying of liver cancer 3 months before her. So you totally got depressed. You know, just life was, I just couldn't understand, you know, why is this stuff happening to me? So food's always your comfort, going through times like that, and, you know, and just got totally out of character for what I did. I stayed in shape pretty good up until then, and for about 2 or 3 years, I just ate pretty much what I wanted to. Woke up January, weighing 266, and I thought, Lord, you allow me to see 60 this August, it's going to be gone. And so I set forth a plan to call my friend Chris Buckholz, who owns Elite Fitness, and told Chris to get me on a plan. So the combination of Chris' workouts in the morning, going to spin classes at Anatomies, doing some stuff on my own, you know, like, you know, running the stadium and stuff like that, and just a good portion control diet, proteins, carbs, fruits, about a gallon of water a day. So you add all that up, 79 pounds since January.
And that's a good point. You have experience staying active and fit.
True.
And you still had to ask someone's guidance. And I think that's what, again, a lot of people just assume, I'm going to lift weights, I'm going to jump on this diet because I saw it on TV, and then they don't get any results and they give up and quit.
You got to have a plan. I mean, that's what I told Chris. I coached with Chris at PCS for 3 years, and I told Buck, I said, Buck, throw me something out there. Let's get busy. I said, I got work to do and a lot to do. So we started off slow, 15, 20 minutes at a time, and then finally gets into what he has, those circuit trainings. And if you ever want somebody to train, you call Chris Buckholz, because he will throw it on you, and you will come out of there with a dry shirt and be dripping sweat. I mean, it's just a great workout. And Pat seen me wear a spin. He sees me coming out of there pretty much dripping wet. So it's like a bank. Mm-hmm. You get out of what you put into it.
Right, yeah.
That's what it's boiled down, what it boils down to.
So your daily routine, your life now, getting through life, you said, looking at 60, usually that's where a lot of people start thinking, well, you know what, I'm almost 60, I'm going to be retiring eventually, why should I work out, why should I bother now?
Well, you know, I mean, I will be 60, and I do need a job. I'm looking for a full-time job, but I was sitting patting my way over. I said, look, wealth without health, useless.
Yeah.
Won't matter. I mean, I said, Lord willing, if I see 60, I'm not going to be one of those that walked out in the yard and dropped dead of a heart attack. Now, I may very well do that.
Right.
We hear about it all the time.
Yeah.
But it's not going to be because I was 266 pounds.
Mm-hmm.
You see, I wasn't. That's not fixing to happen.
Yeah.
And I said, I always tell people, you don't make up your mind, you make up your heart. Because you'll miss it by 1 foot if you make up your mind. I was told to a pastor, I had a lot of football players miss getting college scholarships by 1 foot. That's the difference between your head and your heart.
Mm-hmm.
You can make it up. Everybody wants to be great in their mind. But do you want to be great in your heart?
Yeah.
Big, big, big difference. And you can make up, if you can pull your heartstrings, you can touch your heartstrings, it's not going to happen most of the time.
It's lifestyle.
It's all that's what it boils down to.
Every day, you don't even think about it after a while. It's just what you do on a daily basis.
I'm so used to doing my routine now. I mean, I work about two-hour workout about most of the time, 3 times a day. I have been. I'll cut back a little bit now because I'm at my goal weight. But, I mean, for seriously, all through those cold months and all that, I was getting up and doing the training with Buck and going to spin and doing my running. On the say, you get into a routine, and that's what your body starts to look forward to.
Now, Patrick, like we said, results not typical.
Right.
So I'm sure some runs thinking, well, that's not me.
And I'm going to tell you the truth. 3 workouts a day is not me either.
Mm-hmm.
But it's working for Billy, right?
That sounds great, Billy.
No.
I would love to be able to do 3 workouts.
I got
you said that, I'm like,
things to do.
That's my
one
goal.
But what I'm saying is Billy made a commitment.
Mm-hmm.
And he found a formula that's working. And he's having fun. And he's seeing results. He's seeing change. And so, you know, and that's not everybody's journey. This is his journey. Right now, he has the time available that allows him to get these multiple workouts in. He, you know, these things are working with his lifestyle. You can see success, you know, putting this in 4 or 5 days a week. The issue is that a lot of people, it's the glue that holds you to that commitment, you know. Now, Billy's got great resolve. He's got a tremendous discipline and work ethic, and he woke up. He had a moment, made his mind up. He hasn't faltered since. And a lot of people come in, you know, they haven't quite developed that yet. So getting connected to the right programs that are ideally suited for that individual and the things that they're having fun. And I say that the fitness always follows the fun.
Yeah.
You'll only go so far if you're doing this out of a labor. You know, it's like, well, I've got to reach this goal weight, or I've got to get my cholesterol to this number. And those are great motivators, external motivators that get us and, you know, get that initial momentum. But it's not going to hold you there, because eventually we're all people.
Mm-hmm.
And we just get distracted.
Yeah.
You know? But you find something that you can connect to that's like, man, that was fun. And I think there's so many of us in our community that don't realize how much fun this pursuit can be. And so that's why what we do is so impactful, because of all the diversity, dozens of different programs and people that are connected in every component of our, you know, offerings that are passionate about seeing you succeed. So you don't have to have Billy's resolve and his tenacity to see success. What you do is just got to take that first step.
Mm-hmm.
And then we'll partner with you and carry you the rest of the way. And eventually, guess what? You're doing things just like this,
right.
You know, which is amazing. So it's a good lesson for us. And then the freedom that Billy's got now with you know, that much, 80 pounds off of him, you know, how has that impacted your overall health and your self-esteem? And I mean, he was coming out of depression, significant life challenges and loss that so many of us will face sometime or another in our lives. And exercise has been a great vessel for him, you know. So how has it impacted?
Absolutely. I mean, it's just like I'm a brand new person again. I feel like I'm in my 20s as far as the way I actually feel. I told some friends of this, I got some clothes I didn't realize I could get into. You know, I've got new clothes I can finally get back into. But yeah, I mean, it's just the self-esteem thing alone, you know, is huge. You know, you feel better about yourself, you know, when you know that you put in hard work and you've seen success with it, you feel a degree of accomplishment. So that automatically builds your self-esteem. And it's just, it's been fun to do it. I've had that, it's been hard,
mm-hmm.
You know, I mean, but at the same time, once your body gets used to doing something like that, that's what it gets used to doing.
Right.
And it craves doing the workouts, and I have had the time to go do it. That's why I said I wanted to do it while I had the time,
mm-hmm.
because I do need to, once I get full-time employment, I'll be back to, like everybody else, be be lucky to get in one workout a day.
Right.
So I wanted to be have my goal weight in place, and so I can just kind of settle into a routine of like most people can do.
Yeah, well, that's a great, great story. Congratulations, too.
Thank you.
And
Thank you so much.
Results not typical, but I think everyone who has been to the doctor at some point, the doctor tells you, you need exercise.
That's true.
But that's it. You don't get a list or things to do because that's not the doctor's area. That's where anatomies can come in and help guide you and make sure that it's fun. And if people want to know more, Patrick, what should they do?
Man, all they have to do is pick up the phone and call us, 601-579-9555. They can go online and check us out at anatomies.com. They walk in the front door and somebody will love on them right away, you know.
Yes.
And Billy, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank
That's
you
amazing
so much for the opportunity.
Tremendous
Anatomies
progress.
Anatomies has a great gym. I highly advise people in the area to looking for a gym. Anatomies is where you need to go. They have an unbelievable program for just about everybody.
Billy, thanks so much for coming in.
Thank
and
you.
Hopefully that inspired at least one person to get up and make a change. Patrick,
you can do it.
Yeah, you can.
Yes.
All right, guys.
Heart
thanks set. So much for coming in. 9 a.m. edition continues next. It's William Carey Wednesday. We're talking to Dr. Melissa Stevens of the William Carey University College of Osteopathic Medicine and their partnership with Forest General Hospital. Actually, a bunch of stuff we're going to talk about. It's coming up next. Stay with us.